Welcome into the Cascade Mountaineers Dynasty. We have a matchup against unranked 3-0 Colorado this week. We're number 4 in the country at 5-0, coming off a big win over Stanford last week. Yep, Stanford previously beat Arizona State, who is a top 10 team, and then Utah, who's in the top 25. We're off to a screaming start season. And the big news is new logo, new uniforms, new all over the place for the Mountaineers since the last update in the series. I'm going to save the uniform reveal till we get to the game here. So we're going to go ahead and jump in. But it's been a while since I was since I last uploaded. That's what I've been working on, and I'm really excited for you guys to get a look at what I've been creating. Yeah, the Dynasty.
There's Hi, everybody. The first Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show.
A little bit of gray
presented
in the,
by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
And got new uniforms.
A lot of times, if we say tempo is the key, you think that we're talking about basketball.
Pants didn't get
no.
touched at all.
Tempo is a huge key in this game. We're going to be back at halftime. How long that takes sort of depends on who establishes its tempo.
Home away,
the running team controls the way
that
leads that clock. We'll see
you
in just a few minutes. Passing team pitches it all over the place and runs up numbers on that scoreboard. Might be a while, but we'll still be here. We've done all we can do here. Time
we'll
to tee it up. Let's
one.
Send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
The outline of Washington on one side, number on the other side. Rome. And
it's time for the coin toss
blue.
Now, presented by Coke Zero.
Used a
real cold taste,
oh,
zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Design.
Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up. And he got all of this one. Great
that
kick.
Number font is the same font they're using on the Cascade.
He's to the 20 now. Across the 30. They'll bring him down at the 38.
Hey, that's a pretty good return there to open this game up.
Tackle on the play. They're going to get the ball. I'll just start it. Square around there.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
There we go.
He laterals the ball. He might have a chance. Down the sideline.
All right. Great start.
And he scores.
Oh,
touchdown.
52 yards to start today.
And it's the PAT. Let's throw it out to Reese now for
yeah,
studio
so that'll do it for you. I mean,
Dean
I
is lined up to kick this one off.
Will Watson can do.
Watson from the 2. He's to the 20. At the 30. The 50.
Oh,
and
he gets out of
the
looking
at him yesterday in practice, he looks bigger, he looks stronger, he looks faster. Look out this year. He's going to have a better year this year than he even had last year.
So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
He airs it out.
And it's a good answer. This game we play, we scored on a 44-yard touchdown pass from Vinny Rice to Yannick Isaac.
This is one of those plays you just sit back and admire. The quarterback threw the ball perfectly. And again, the speed of the receiver is the difference in this play.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he tacks on the extra point.
First
and 10,
all
on the 23-yard line.
That's to the triple option. Situation, so what they can do
from their own 18-yard line
isn't.
It's third down.
Okay, it's still a wing formation here. There's a pass.
He's under some heat.
He throws that interception.
He telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
He covered that fumble. After the huge breakdown in the first two plays.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm established.
Pretty solid.
For such a negative play to happen, loss of yards, that can really have a negative impact on the offense and what they're trying to do.
He's taken down at the 41. About 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Knocked him down for a loss. Weiss is the kind of athlete that you can build your entire offense around. His athleticism, second to none. We'll see if they have an answer for him today.
Ooh, missed.
Sure, we've still got more than half to play. But this
down.
Is a perfect chance to get some points.
Too.
I don't know why they went for it here on fourth down.
Well, I guess it's easy for us in hindsight to say that he should have kicked the field goal. But I thought that was a no-brainer to begin with. The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
He's got a lot of time to forget about that last hit. He just got to stick to the game plan. Well, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. But somehow, he was able to throw the ball away.
From their own 24-yard line. Second down.
He can really pick up a good head of steam before he encounters any potential defender. That was a well played. Well played by our defense.
Big opening. Tackle made at the 40-yard line. And the fullback picks up the first.
Huge gain there on the ground.
That was J.P. Harrison, man. I didn't like that the game didn't.
From the 40-yard line, first down.
There,
and now he pitches it. And they make the stop around the 37-yard line.
Was clobbered by three defenders.
They bring the nose
down as a tour to their like a pass on that play. So it's not a sack. We just have the wind getting. Credit for it. That's third and nine. They're going full receiver set here.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 30. He's tackled around the 22-yard line.
Completion of the day from the Mets. It's a 17-yard pickup for the first down. Marcus Simmons.
That makes it first and 10.
Rushed on the catch, but holds on for the first time.
Brought down after a nice little
5 yards.
That's good. second and five. It's second and five here. Ball on the 17. The 10.
The 10 and able to bring down Isaiah Cockett. He gets an important touchdown on the play. The Buffalo regained the lead on the turnover on down.
And he converts the extra point. Here's an update from the studio and restate.
Alabama.
The Commodores were ranked 18. After that face plant, they'll be lucky to be ranked at all next week. And for Alabama, their winning streak reaches 5.
Colorado, ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick.
Getting his chance to return this kickoff.
Oh, tackle made at the 18.
A very good block, and it's going to be a brutal return. Azambuco.
They went for it on fourth down on their last possession and weren't successful.
This offense comes out on the field again after being stopped on downs last time out. And not only does that affect them in a negative way, but you know what it does? It gives this defense that they're facing a ton of confidence and a lot of momentum as they come back out on the field.
Crazy, this is already
it's second and
drive.
Six. Ball on the 22. Makes it to the 22-yard line.
For whatever reason, I'm not going to give any forward progress on that play. No gain. I think we got about 2 yards, though, if they give him progress.
Got an opening. He's out to the 30. He's to the 40. Across midfield. And he's taken down right around the 32-yard line.
Big first down.
So we've got a first down after a great running play.
Adrian checks in with my field.
And he's tackled.
6 yards there. First down.
Nothing more effective that a team can do offensively than to pound the ball right at the defense, trying to wear them down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 15. Down around the 7-yard line. That makes it 2nd and 2.
7 yards to go for a touchdown. This one.
On the ground, right side. Tackle at the 5.
2 yards.
A yard, maybe two on the carry.
You have to like how this linebacker was able to move up quickly and bring down the ball carrier for a short game. Nice stop by the junior.
Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. And it pays off.
Touchdown. 5 yards. Tied it up. 57 seconds to go.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. An 8-play, 83-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage. And it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
We're deadlined right now at 14.
Set up by good.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Second drive, followed by being the touchdown drive. On the next drive, so interesting.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of the defense.
And he throws it away.
This is first and 2 was actually our defenders.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25.
defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that these defense is putting on him.
And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line.
I can remember the year that this young man in Florida this year has everybody buzzing about the kind of season he can have this year. The last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this
game.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From the 41-yard line, it's second down. He throws. It's the safety. Sheds a tackle. It's the safety who's in the right place at the right time.
The quarterback has to know where the safety is when he makes this kind of throw. Right here, he just tried to force something that wasn't there.
So at the end of one, 14 apiece. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 33. Now he pitches it. He's pushed out of bounds at the 47-yard line.
What is that? That play didn't even make sense. What?
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
From their own 44-yard line, it's second down. And they push him out around the 42-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series.
Hey, watch the screen, watch the screen. Watch the screen. Check 59. Mike.
And they'll get him in the backfield. He had nowhere to go on that option play.
You're right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 44. Around the
38-yard
line.
I should have been able to see the running back coming outside and instead
Here's play number 10 on the drive.
He's back. He's not going to matter.
You know, as a defender, anytime you're not going to have a chance to get to the quarterback, one of the things all defensive coaches try to teach their defense is to get your hands up and try to knock the football away. And that time, that's exactly what they did to set up this fourth down.
Colorado is looking to go up by three. It's up. And this is no good. He didn't have the leg for it. And watch out, because they can return this. They leave 3 points on the field there. We're deadlocked right now at 14. From their own 29-yard line, it's first down. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. He's knocked out by us at the 45-yard line.
That's always a big blow to a defense to give up a long run like that. You'll see a lot of those guys hanging their head.
And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. It's an after his receiver on hurry, and he's immediately tackled. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. He's scrambling. He gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Gets to about the 34-yard line. First down. He's going to try and scramble. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He goes out of bounds. That's the 27-yard line.
But it's nothing going for Huntley up the middle.
That makes it third and three. So we're looking at another third down here.
Excellent job here by the defense to snip that one out before it turned into a first down.
That'll make it fourth and two. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Gets to about the 27-yard line. Second down. And now he pitches it. And he makes the stop at about the 29-yard line.
36.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. He's finally tackled at the 32.
For big game. And Tony Parker chooses to take the quarterback and come back around right past him. Ball there.
He's at the 20. Inside the 10. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. He's up to 100 rushing yards now.
You just can't say enough about the job the offensive line has done. They've kept the running lanes open and given him all kinds of space to maneuver.
First and goal, and if they can execute, we'll be all tied up. They're packed in tight on the line. Touchdown, Colorado!
And that's a quick answer for the Buffalo, so we'll make every possible play. It's cheese.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game.
It's
the PAT. A six-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big runs.
Yeah, stalemate right now, 21 apiece. Well, Herbie, if nothing else, we're keeping Reese Davis busy because the updates are coming from our game.
Yeah, and the good thing about so many updates is Pollock doesn't have any room to talk because all it is Reese and these highlights.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Here's the screen to the wideout.
He lost gets a leg. It's
the 41.
For a first down. You're opposing. Defense is really happy to see some loss graduate from the year.
First and 10. All on the 41. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. He wants it all going long.
It's going to be the second interception of the day. It's going to be this underthrow back pass.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at it. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
From the 49-yard line, it's first down.
That line is not great. Because the hot dog line. Yeah,
and he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into cover. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Does not have his effect of the game drastically with that one.
You got to give the receiver a chance to make the play. That was just underthrown.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39. Under pressure, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. Mountaineers taking their first time out of the back.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Awesome. chance to return this ball.
Watson will be the return man.
Very defense player specialist.
He drops it.
And everything's going on.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
Always the jump. Trying to catch him.
Can't get away from the pressure. Boy, this defense really came to play today.
Well, they said before the game that they wanted to put a lot of pressure on this quarterback. They sure stuck to that plan.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long.
Sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
He heaves it to the end zone. Almost intercepted.
Here we got Beaver adjusts. Gets back to the ball. Attempted to run another. Yeah, we're going to get
it. It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Colorado could take the lead with this field goal. It has the distance. And it hits the upright. No good. And he missed it off the upright. And it's off the upright. No good.
Anybody who tells you that football isn't a game of inches might want to have a talk with this kicker. It doesn't get any closer than that.
Here comes the offense, hoping to erase the memory of the fumble on their last drive.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
On the run, right side. Makes it out to about the 39.
He made a good decision to take off there.
The Mountaineers call a timeout. That's their second of the half. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Around the 48-yard line.
Very
the screen pass goes nowhere.
Well, you got to take your hat off to the defense. All week they preached over and over again how they were not going to let this kid use his speed in the open field, and they really shut him down that time.
He launches one and for the end zone. No, incomplete.
All right. Absolutely thriving.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here.
Kill.
Kind of surprising here that they didn't elect to punt. I don't agree with this call.
Kill.
Kill. Kill. Kill. Kill.
He's going to
air it long.
What are you doing, dude? Come on.
Questionable play call. Get that one on the coaching staff. It's way too early in the game to be going for it on fourth down. I would have punted the ball in that situation.
They can really pay for it now unless their defense comes out here and makes a big defensive stop. They missed a chance at 3 points on their last drive.
Yep. It was a rough go around for this kicker the last time. But this guy won't hang his head. If he has another opportunity to kick one, he'll be ready to go.
Going long. Into coverage, and the defense has it.
Inexplicably turned inside, runs right back into a massive enemies. Could have had a chance at a return, but that poor decision making was going to cast him and just turned right back into a receiver.
We played a half.
Oh, I
21 ball game.
Fortunate, but I don't know how to say it. It's like, I feel like we played very poorly.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
If that makes
David Pollock and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. These two defenses so far, they've been everything they've been advertised to be.
Heading into the third quarter now. Tie ball game. We're set to resume play. It's fielded at the two. Heading for the corner. And he's taken down at the 39.
Nice return from Mazin.
Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful.
Complete. He's up to two receptions, 2 yards. That's star here. Getting shut down by the Buffs. Okay.
From their own 40-yard line. Second down. Throws it in a hurry. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. Inside the 30. Second down.
That sacked. I'm not quite sure what the goal of that play is. You essentially allow him to get some pressure. He has to break a sack. Here you go. There's no way around that play. Cool. Wide open. He got trapped tonight as Nukes on a rub route there.
First down, 10 yards to go.
Buffs muddy up the secondary and end up with a solid
false start.
Again.
False start. Just a middle lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Still first down.
First pick up a five on the option to the fullback.
That brings up second and nine.
Second and nine. Ball on the 46-yard line.
A one decides to tackle
nice
him.
To the outside.
Play that option play incredibly well and just tackles him. They just kind of watch him. Keep him to push and doesn't. He gets a nice game. Does not have the muscle to bring down Caden Lee before he gets a first down if arms his way for the first down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. He's tackled around the 26-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Jones with a pitch. Inside the 10. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice game. First and goal from the 5 and looking to cap this off with a touchdown.
And Mike no runs things tied up.
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there.
The extra point to tie this game up. He makes
and
the
PAT.
Separates a good team from a great team is being able to make the adjustments at halftime and come out and being able to execute. And so far, we've seen both these offenses able to do that.
And down he goes to the 36-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 36. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Up the middle for a nice game.
Gaining 4 yards.
That'll bring up 3rd and 2.
It's 3rd down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. He throws it. Caught with room.
Kevin Davis gets the touchdown.
Huge play. What a catch and a big touchdown from the tight end.
I'll tell you, this tight end is a big-time football player. He might like to talk a little bit out there on the field, but he has the type of
game. There we go.
And doesn't it always seem like he just finds a way to get open? And he hits the PAT. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Decent run here. Right,
it's 4 yards on the end round.
That makes it 7-6.
It's second and six. Ball on their own 29.
Easy.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 44.
Instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
Let's go pay off.
And now he pitches it. He's taken down at the 26. Maybe three yards on that. And the ball carrier wasn't getting away from that tackle.
The four wide receivers set through the box.
From their own 46-yard line. It's third down.
It's the interception.
This safety always seems to be in the right place at the right time. It's no surprise that he comes up with the interception here.
From their own 33-yard line. First down.
First and 10, second and 5. Here in the play.
Easy! Flare! I need the play! Kill! Panther 2!
Chucks it downfield.
And he blinks as the freshman. It was a 62-yard touchdown. Weiss.
And for Weiss, he gets his third touchdown pass of the game.
He's been letting it fly today, and his receivers are making plays. That is a great touchdown.
And he adds the extra point. Sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 21. Today has not gone very well for this young man.
Well, right now the defense is doing a great job of applying pressure on this quarterback. And I think that's creating the turnover opportunities. Even when this quarterback does have time to throw, I think he feels that pressure because the defense has done such a good job of applying that pressure throughout the game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He's to the 40, and down he goes. Right around the 44-yard line. And for Duncan, that puts him over the 100-yard rushing mark.
He's running very well today.
Really sure
they've been smart to keep him involved in the rushing attack.
No idea where...
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. He makes it to the 45-yard line.
Makes it to get two touchdowns and into the final quarter here after touchdowns to Davis and Adewale.
Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Yard line. You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
First and 10. Ball on the 36 yard line. And bring him down around the 38 yard line.
Quarterback
trying to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get it out to the back so he can do something with it.
This game.
He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 17.
Really up, screen down, goes down. Inside the bus.
His defense has been bringing the blitz and is having success getting to him.
And one other impressive stat is their takeaway total. 4. This defense is brutal.
This defense is still feeling the pressure of the passing game.
Yeah, pretty decent average. So if they can do more of that, it'll swing the pressure around.
Good shot to the other receiver, and he can't hang on to it. From their own 17-yard line, second down.
Defensive end in guard. Oh, I'm getting with another one. Same slant pass, same coverage. Not able to come up with the first time grab.
Throws left.
Oh, three drops in a row for him. Get him out of the game. Every single one of them would have been a first down, except not able to grab it.
Watson is back deep to return.
Cool performance from Ellenberg.
Room around the corner. He's at the 40. And he's taken down the 31-yard line.
Every single pass puts him right in the hands. And he gets nothing.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Second on the first.
That brings him second and five. It's second and 5 here. Ball on the 26. And he's tackled at the 28.
Loss of 2 on this play. 3rd and 7 coming.
Call it a loss of
of 2 yards on the play. That makes it 3rd and 7.
Kill, kill, kill!
He's looking for 6.
And Weiss finds Adelon in the back end of 28-yard touchdown pass. Adelon catches his 2nd. Weiss throws his 4.
Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him 6.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
It's 1 foot down, right before the back line of the end zone. And it's a 28.
And he converts the extra point. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injury.
Four turnovers, so can't blame too hard.
From their own 25-yard line, it's 2nd down.
The interception's a fumble. Not a bad day here. The experience of superpower.
Under pressure, they bring the quarterback down.
Sack a ton, too. Another example of why the triple option is not a winning strategy in modern culture. It's 4th and 20. That's where you're going to punt back to Mountaineers. But this one will in hand.
Watson will be the return man. Watson takes it to 47.
Nice take. It's 12 yards. It's going to the 35 yard. 4 minutes, 20 seconds.
The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
He gets out to about the 35-yard line.
Upsetting everything and a hold on the 100 yards.
From the 35-yard line, it's 2nd down.
Touchdown. And it's officially a
That's his 3rd trip to the end zone.
If I were the head coach of this football team, I would give him the ball at least 30 times a game.
And he hits the PAT. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
They vacated the middle of the field by the formation.
And for Oregon State, they're looking to win 2 in a row.
They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. At the 30. Tackle made at the 34. And there's a penalty on the play. Let's see who it's on.
Holding. Holding on the receiver. That's going to move him back.
Well, if you want to ruin a drive, just grab a hold of a defender's jersey.
You're not getting any breaks right now.
I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here. But that being said, we could still see some exciting plays.
Back, finally catches a pass after his 3 drives on him.
1st and 10. And drives. All the 29-yard line.
Switch, switch, switch. Here we go.
Makes the grab past the marker.
Herdian Spencer gets a 14-yard grab. Now might be over 100 yards. Yeah, he's at 109 now. Remington man beater, so we might have to.
He's at the 40. To the 20. And they make the stop at the 13-yard line.
Isaac Burgley. Burgley. Big 43-yard gain down into Mountaineers territory. Another quarterback is entering the game here for the...
So we've got a first down after a great running play. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Here they come. And he's taken down at the 13. There's a flag on the field, and I think I have a good feeling of what this might be.
Offense. All right, not what I was expecting. Flag.
That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
It's first down and a lot. Throws it to the outside.
Well, Simmons gets still playing hard out there. Enough game is the
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive. That's perfect timing between a quarterback and his wide receiver. He recognized the middle of the field was wide open. And I really thought the quarterback kind of looked the safety off to open that play up to the middle and then made the perfect throw for the touchdown.
Locked down at the 45.
And there's going to be a flag for a face mask.
Personal foul.
Yep, face mask. There it is.
Defense.
Oh, we're going to get really nice field goal.
Still first down.
Still trying to burn the clock. I promise we are trying to burn it.
And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns and 2 possessions.
I expect him to run the ball, kill the clock, and put this one in the books.
Makes it to the 17.
This is bad, but...
From the 17-yard line, first down.
96 yards to drive ago. Big down, checking in.
A little over a minute in the game.
First down, 6 yard gain.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
On the timeout, so we'll go ahead and move the ball down.
Dog 4, 3, 9.
Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback.
One more time, but that'll do it for this. Pac-12 battle in the Buffs and the Mountaineers. Cascade taking it 63-35, including the 6-0. And in Colorado, their first loss of the season. Buffs dropped to 3-1.
He takes a knee.
Thank you for watching this edition of the Cascade Mountaineers Dynasty. Back next week, hopefully a top. Hopefully we can break the number.
Mountaineers know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be the next one.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance. And really, the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14.
Thank you for watching.
This is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.